We're going to look at the different sizes of PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, sometimes called on-site twin and earth cables, but can also be referred to as 70 degrees thermoplastic PVC insulated and sheathed flat cable with a protective conductor in the regulations. So we'll look at it first of all from the conductor sizes point of view. So starting from the left to the right, when we talk about the size of these cables, so twin and CPC cables, we're always referring to the live conductors. And from previous video presentations, we know the live conductors are both the line and neutral. And we can see that the brown conductor here is the line conductor and the blue conductor is the neutral. So therefore they are the live conductors. So when describing these cables and we say, for instance, the far left hand side is 1 mm², we're talking about the live conductors, the line and neutral. In that cable on the far left hand side, the live conductors are 1 mm². And often in the workshop, we'll be referring to those as 1 mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, twin being the two live conductors and the CPC. So that's nice and clear. However, it comes a little bit different when we think about the CPC on its own. However, that cable on the left-hand side, which is 1 mm², also has a CPC, the center conductor there, which we will sheath with green and yellow sleeving at identification at termination, is also 1 mm². So that's nice and straightforward and simple. That's something we need to remember. We need to remember both the live conductor sizes in relationship to the CPC. So on the left-hand side in our 1 mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, both the live conductors are 1 mm² and the CPC is also 1 mm². If we come in from the left to the next one, this cable here, obviously it's a PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, but its size is 1.5 mm². So the line and neutral in this cable are 1.5 mm². This time, however, the CPC isn't the same size. It is smaller. It is 1 mm². And we will say in the workshop, why can the CPC be smaller? And why can it have no sheath on it? In other words, be uninsulated. And the answer that I'd expect from you in the early part of your studies is to say the following. The CPC is not sheathed throughout the run of its cable because under normal conditions, it will not carry current and can be smaller in size for the same reason. So it doesn't do anything under normal conditions. However, if there is a fault to earth, the CPC will carry current for a maximum of 5 seconds. However, we will look at other maximum disconnection times throughout our studies, but 5 seconds being the absolute maximum the CPC will carry current for before the circuit should disconnect. So that's why we have, in some instances, a smaller CPC in this style of cable. And we'll see other styles of cable moving forward where the CPC is of equal size to the live conductors, but we're looking at twin and CPC cables here. So we've got the first cable on the left-hand side is 1 mm² for the two live conductors, and the CPC is also 1 mm². The second one in from the left is 1.5 mm² for line and neutral, in other words, the live conductors. And this time the CPC is a reduced size of 1 mm². However, as we look at those two cables, you can see the construction of the conductors are all solid copper. Okay, and that's important to remember the sizes in relationship to the construction. So they're solid copper. If we move to the third one, so third in from the left, we've now got 2.5 mm² twin and CPC cable. So the line and neutral are 2.5. And this time the CPC isn't 1 mm and it isn't 2.5, it's the conductor size in between. It's a 1.5 mm² CPC. So live conductors are 2.5 mm² and the CPC is 1.5 mm². And again, the first three cables all have solid copper conductors. So if we go for the fourth cable now, the fourth cable, we can see a subtle difference already on the line and neutral. So the live conductors are solid stranded copper cable and the CPC is a solid copper conductor. So this cable size here for the live conductors, line and neutral, is 4 mm² and the CPC, this one catches most people out and has been asked many times as an exam question, what size is the CPC in a 4 mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable? The answer is it's 1.5 mm². So in that cable there, we've got a 1.5 mm² CPC. Note the construction now, that once we get above 2.5, so cable number three being our 2.5 mm² twin and CPC cable, once we jump up from 2.5 to 4 millimeter squared cables, our construction now changes to solid stranded copper conductors. So if we go for the next one, so we're looking at cable number 5 now. Cable number 5 is got live conductors of solid stranded copper again, and these are 6 millimeters squared for the live conductors, and this time the CPC is 2.5 millimeters squared. So we can see from these first 5 cables that if a conductor is between 1 millimeter squared and 2.5 millimeters squared in cross-sectional area, that its construction is of a solid copper conductor. When we go above 2.5 millimeters squared, in other words to 4 millimeters squared, we can see that it's solid stranded copper. And we need to remember that. So that cable there is 6 millimeter squared PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, and it has a 2.5 millimeter squared CPC. If we look at cable number 6, we can see now that we've got all the conductors of solid stranded copper. Therefore, hopefully we can deduce from that that none of the conductors there will be 2.5, because when we get bigger than 2.5, we change from a solid single conductor to solid stranded conductors. And this cable here is 10 millimeters squared for the live conductors. So in other words, line and neutral are 10 millimeters squared, and the CPC is 4 millimeters squared. So we can see there in the center that we've got a solid stranded copper circuit protective conductor, and it is 4 millimeters squared. Our final cable, so far right, our PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, this time this is 16 millimeters squared, so line and neutral are 16 millimeters squared, and the center circuit protective conductor is 6 millimeters squared. Remembering the CPC can be smaller, and is not sheathed because under normal conditions, it doesn't carry any current. It'll only carry current under fault conditions to earth for a maximum of 5 seconds. Remember, we use copper as our conductive material because it has a very low or very good resistivity. And we'll talk about that in our electrical science and principles lesson. In other words, it's a very good conductor. We know that pre-2004, so these are post-2004, so after 2004, these were our cable colours for our single phase supply. So brown is line and blue is neutral, identifying our CPC with green and yellow sleeving. Pre-2004, we had a different set of colours. We had a line conductor that was red and a neutral conductor that was black. And often our CPC was still identified with green and yellow sleeving. If you go back in history further, you will see how the CPC colour could have been green in the past, etc. We'll touch on that in the classroom as well. So for this part, I need us to remember our cable sizes for PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, something you'll call on site twin and earth cable. So from left to right, we're going to describe it in the form of the live conductors. So the first cable is a 1 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable. Then it's 1.5 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable, 2.5 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable. And then we've got a 4 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable, a 6 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable, a 10 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable. And then finally, the largest size of this cable that we can get is a 16 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable. And if we go back to the start and we talk about just the CPCs, the first cable has a 1 millimeter squared CPC. Cable number 2 also has a 1 millimeter squared CPC. Cable number 3 has a 1.5. Cable number 4 has a 1.5 millimeter squared CPC. Cable number 5 has a 2.5 millimeter squared CPC. And we know that from construction that they're all solid. When we jump onto the next cable, cable number 6, we can see its construction of the CPC has changed, and that is a 4 millimeter squared CPC. And then our final cable, again, has a stranded solid conductor and is of 6 millimeter squared cable. So these are all things that we need to get used to talking about and using within the electrical workshop, and getting the appropriate sizes of both the live conductors, line and neutral, and the CPC correct for both work in the workshop and for our online exams. And as always, I hope this video has been some help.